Assalamualaikum student, I am your physics teacher from IYC school. So first I like to share some instruction. Take a screenshots of every slide that will be shared and do your all the home tasks in your fair copies. So in today's class we continue the chapter 12, waves and sound. And in this chapter we are considering or we will study about the numericals. Okay, so first we are going to revise the basic definitions and the formulas which are related to our numericals, because that will help you to remind all the numericals. So we will consider. So the first definition is wave. It is a phenomena in which the disturbance is created in a medium, or we can say that a wave is a vibratory disturbance through a material or a medium or a space. I mean to say that for the vibratory disturbance, we need a material or a medium. Means medium is necessary for the propagation of a waves. So waves transfers energy without transferring mass. Okay, means that disturbance is moving, not a mass is moving. So when we disturb any thing, so it means we are creating a waves in it. Now the characteristics of the waves. So characteristic is wavelength. As we have told you that wavelength means it is a length, it is a distance. So to understand the wavelength, first we have to understand crust and trough. As you can see in a diagram that the mean position indicated by the dotted line. So the area above the crust, above the mean position, is indicated a crust, and the area which is below the mean position is considered as a trough. Okay, and the distance between the crust and a trough is considered as a wavelength. And do remember that it is a distance, so its unit is again meter. Now the amplitude. Amplitude, do you remember that what is amplitude? Yes, amplitude is the maximum displacement from the mean position. I hope you will understand that it is a maximum displacement from a mean position. And do remember that if the waves are creating disturbing, or waves are creating, so above the mean position or below the mean position, we have many points where the displacement is occurred. But the maximum displacement is the point which is known as amplitude. Okay, the maximum displacement is known as amplitude. Now the frequency. Frequency is the reciprocal of the time period, or we can say that frequency is the number of waves which passes a fixed point. So student, do remember that what is frequency and what is the formula of a frequency and what is the unit of a frequency, because it will help you to understand the numericals. Okay, so what is frequency? Frequency is the number of waves that passes a fixed point in a unit time. Okay, and we can also use the formula numbers of vibration divided by the time, or 1/T. We can also use the formula for frequency as the reciprocal of the time period. And the formula of a unit of a frequency is hertz, and we denote it as by Hz. Okay, so time period, again time period is a reciprocal of focal length. And what is time period? Time period means the time required to complete a one cycle. Okay, so the time required to complete a one cycle. And what do you understand by one cycle? One cycle means a complete crust and a trough is considered as a one cycle. Okay, or a rarefaction and a compression combinedly form a one cycle. Now the formulas which are used for the numericals, these are the formulas which we are going to use in our numericals. So the first formula is about the wave velocity. Wave velocity formula is v is equals to lambda into f, and what is stand for v? V stand for velocity of a wave. Lambda stand for a wavelength. This is the symbol which we are using for the wavelength. And F stand for the frequency. Okay, so remember it, that the formula of a wave velocity is V is equals to lambda F. Lambda means wavelength, F means frequency. And V stand for velocity. Now the time period for the pendulum. Time period for the pendulum, formula for the time period of pendulum is indicated by T is equals to 2 pi under root L over G. So T stands for time period. 2 is a constant value and pi. Pi is also a constant value, that is 3.14 or 22 over 7. So these are the constant value. And under root L over G, L stands for length. And the length of the pendulum will be considered as a length from the point of suspension to the center of gravity of the sphere, or we can say that only a center of the sphere. Okay, so in a denominator we have g, and you know very well that small g is considered as a acceleration due to gravity. That small g is stand for the acceleration due to gravity, and you know also very well that its value is also constant. We take 10 or 9.8 meter per second square. That is the value of time period for the pendulum. Okay. Now we are moving towards the next formula, that is frequency. As we have discussed that frequency is defined as the number of vibration in a unit time. So we write number of vibration, and class, do remember it, that number of vibration does not have any unit. And why it does not have any unit? Because these are the numbers, these are the quantities. Okay, for example, we have 40 waves, 50 waves, 30 waves are passing in a unit time. So that doesn't require any unit, because these are the numbers, these are the quantities. Okay, so the second formula for the frequency is, so f is equals to 1 over t. As I told you that frequency is the reciprocal of a time period. Okay, so do remember it, that we can use the formula for frequency as the number of vibration divided by time, and frequency is 1 over t. That is all. We are using both formulas, and why we are using both formulas, it depends upon the numericals, the given values which are given in the numerical. So we are using the one of them formula accordingly. Now time period for the wave. So time period of the waves is again the reciprocal of the frequency, or we can say that t is equals to 1 over f. Okay, so 1 over f means here f stands for frequency and t stands for time period. So I hope take a screenshot of that slide. It will be helpful for you for doing the numericals, because all the formula were in front of you, and we were using that formulas to understand the numericals. Okay, so take a screenshots of that slide, and then we are moving toward the new slide or a new topic, or we can say that we are starting a numericals. So here is the numerical number 1, that is 12.1. The wavelength of a wave is 0.1 nanometer. So its speed is 3 into 10 raised to power 8 meter per second. And what is the frequency of the wave? As you can see that in a formula, first we have to write the data. And in our data, we were right given quantities. As you can see in a question, in a numerical, that the wavelength is 0.1 nanometer. So first we have to change that nanometers into meters. So 1 meter is equals to 10 raised to power minus 9 nanometer. So that's why we multiply the given value with 10 raised to power minus 9, and it will change into a meter. Okay. And now the speed. Speed is also given in a numerical, that is 3 into 10 raised to power 8 meter per second. And the required quantity is frequency. So take a screenshot of that slide, in this slide data, and the required values given, and the required values are given. So take a screenshot so that you can do your work in your copies. Okay, so we are moving toward the next slide. I hope you have taken the screenshots. Now we are moving toward the next, toward the solution of the numerical number 1. As we have, I told you that in the frequency of the wave is required. So Plus, do remember it that for to find the frequency of the wave, we are using a wave equation, that is V is equals to lambda f. And why we are not using the formula of the frequency, that is number of vibration divided by time or 1 over t, we are not using that formula. So why we are not using that formula? Because we are going to use the formula according to the numerical, according to the given values, that what is given and what is required. So it is depend upon the data at which values are given. So we are going to use that formula. So we transform the formula, that is V is equals to F lambda. So we have V is equals to lambda into F, and lambda and F are multiply with each other. They are the product with each other. They are multiply with each other. So to find the frequency, we don't have to shift the frequency. Do remember that when if the required quantity is present in a numerator, so don't move it, don't shift it. Shift the other quantities which are present on that required value, which are present with that required value. So here the wavelength is multiplied with the frequency. So we are shifting that wavelength to the other side. And wavelength is multiplied with the frequency. So when we are shifting it towards the other side, it will divide it with the velocity. So the transformation of the formula will become F is equals to V over lambda. As we know that the velocity of the wave is not numerical, is given as 3 into 10 raised to power 8. So we replace the quantities by their values. And the value of wavelength is 0.1 into 10 raised to power minus 9. Now we do the calculation, and you know very well that how we solve that numericals. First, we have to calculate the numerical values or the decimal values. So 3 divided by 0.1. First, we have to do that division and apply the law on this portion, or we can say that on these values, we can apply the law. So when we divided 3 by the 0.1, the answer is 30. And we are going to apply the law that the two numbers are divided with each other. Their bases are same. So their exponents will be subtracted. So we subtract 8 minus minus 9. So and that 2 minus are multiplied with each other, and we get 8 plus 9. So that's why we get a positive sign. Okay. Then we add the two exponent, 8 and 9 become 17, and the answer will be 30 into 10 to the power 17. Now here we can also do one more step, and that is only a simplification. So do remember it, that it is only a simplification, that what we are doing, that we can write 30 in the form of 3 into 10, because again when we multiply 3 by the 10, the answer is again a 30. So that's why we split the 30 into its factor, or we can say that we break the 30 into its factor, that is 3 into 10. And why we break it into 10? Because so that the exponent of the 10 will be added with the 17, and the answer can be written in the exponential form. That's why we break the 30 into its factor of 10. Okay, so that now we will add the exponent. 17 plus 1 become 18. So this is the answer of frequency, and the formula of the frequency is hertz. So take a screenshot of this numerical. It will be helpful for you to do your copy work. Now that is the next numerical, that a tuning fork vibrate 256 times each second and produce a wave 1.3 meter long. So calculate the period and the velocity of the wave. So first we make a data, and in our data, as you can see, that frequency is given, and that frequency is 256 hertz. Okay, and wavelength is 1.3 meter. Okay, so class, here you have to just understand one thing, that in a numerical they have told you that a tuning fork vibrate 256 times each second. Okay, 256 times each second. So 256 times is the number of vibration, and in each second means 256 divided by 1. And when 256 divided by 1, one is the time period. Do remember it, that one is the time period, because in a numerical they told you that 250 times each second. So we takes 1 second as a given value. So we divided 256 by the 1, and the answer is again 256. So that's why we just write here that frequency is 256 hertz. Okay, so do remember it, that we have find that value from the numericals, but in a numerical 256 times each second. So the we in a denominator we have 1, so that's why the value will remain same. So frequency is 256 hertz. Now the wavelength is 1.3 meter. Now the required time required is the time period and the wave velocity. Now take a screenshot of this slide, because the data and the given and required data is here. So we are moving, then we are moving toward the next slide where the solution is done. Okay, we are moving toward the next slide. Here is the solution of that numerical, that in a numerical first we have to find the time period. So as we have find the frequency, so we take that formula t is equals to 1 over f, and we replace f by their values, and the value is 256. So now we divide 1 to divided by 256, and the value will become 0.0039 second. This is the numerical value of time period. And now we are writing that numerical's value, that decimal value, into the exponential form. And why we write it? Because it's the rule of our books that we have to shift the decimal after the first non-zero number. So as you can see that we have 0, 0 and 3. See, 3 is the first non-zero number. So we have to shift that 0 after the first non-zero number. Okay. So first non-zero number from the right side, as you can see here we have 0, 0 and 0. So the first non-zero number from the right side is the 3. So we shift the decimal after the first non-zero number, that is 3. So when we shift decimal after the 3, so the value will become 3.9. Okay. And as we shift that decimal from the left to right, so that's why the exponent of the 10 will become -3. We replace, we multiply the factor 3.9 by the 10, and its exponent will be depend upon the position of the decimal. So decimal is moving from the left to the right, so that's why we write minus sign. And how many digits it jump? 1, 2 and 3. 3 digits it jump from, so that's why we write the exponent value as a 3. So now the value will become 3.9 into 10 raised to power -3 seconds. I hope you will understand it, that how we can write the decimal values into our exponential value. First, we have to shift the decimal after the first non-zero number. And the first non-zero number is 3. So we shift the decimal from here to 3. And we multiply that factor 3.9 by the 10. Because it's a rule to write the exponential value in as the base of 10. So that's why we write 10 here. And how we write the exponent? As the decimal is jump 3 digits, so that's why the numerical value of the exponent is 3. And why we place negative sign? Because the decimal is moving from the left side to the right side, and that's why we replace it by the negative sign. So take a screenshot of that slide, so it will be helpful for you to do that numericals. And class, do remember it, that try to do practice of converting that decimal value to the exponential values, because it will helpful for you in our physics as well as in our maths. Okay, so now we are shift moving toward a new slide. V, for the V, in this numerical, first we have to find a time period in a part A, and in a part B we have to find the velocity of the wave. So here is the formula of the wave equation, or the velocity of the wave, which is V is equals to lambda into F. So we replace the lambda, that is wavelength, by its numerical value 1.3, and frequency replaced by its numerical value 2.6, and the answer is 332.8 meter per second. Okay. So take a screenshot of that slide, and we will shift toward the next one. here is the next numerical. So the numerical is about, it is 12.3. Let a radio station broadcast an AM radio waves whose frequency is 1230 × 10³ hertz, and the FM radio whose wave frequency is 91.9 × 10⁶ hertz. Find the distance between the adjacent crust in each wave. The speed of AM and FM radio wave is 3×10⁻¹⁰ centimeter per second. Okay, class. So here we have to remember that what we have to find. Here they doesn't write directly the name of the required quantity, and they just write the definition of that quantity. They find the distance between the adjacent crust in each wave. And root, remember that the distance between the two adjacent crust or the trough is known as wavelength. So they in that numerical, they do not write the directly the name of the required quantity, but they write the definition of that quantity. Okay, so the data of that numerical will become as a frequency of AM radio. As you can see in a slide, a frequency of AM radio is we write a symbol F and AM for the AM radio and FM for the FM radio. So this is a given value of frequency of AM radio, and this is a given value of frequency of FM radio, and the speed is also given in centimeter per second. So we are not going to change that centimeter per second to a meter per second, because it doesn't affect. If it is in a CGS system, if the given value is in a CGS system, so we continue solve the numerical with the same value, and we will then use it in the same CGS system. Okay, because it does not affect the system. Now this is the solution of the numerical. That we are using a formula, that is V is equals to lambda F. Okay, so again, what we have to find, we have to find the wavelength. So we again shift the frequency toward the other side, and as we can see that the lambda and frequency are multiplied with each other, so we shift it to the other side, and the numerical and the formula will become V is equals to F AM. Okay, now we replace the quantities by their values. So the value of the velocity is 3.0 × 10⁻¹⁰, and the value of frequency is 1230 × 10³. Okay, so how we do the calculation? First, we divide the decimals values, that is 3.0 divided by 1230. First, we do that calculation. First, we do the division of that decimal values, and then we can shift it toward the law which is applied in this values. So here we do another simplification step. You can also do directly that first divide the value and then shift the value, then shift the decimal. If the value is written as 1230, so where is the decimal of that value? Yes, the decimal of that value is just after the last digit, that is after the zero. And as according to the rule, we have to shift that decimal toward the to the first non-zero number. So as you can see that in this figure, 1230 figure, the first non-zero number is 1. As you can see from the right side, the first non-zero number is 1. So we shift the decimal to the first non-zero number. And at this time, the decimal is shift from the right to the left. Okay, from right to the left. And how many digits it jump? 1, 2, and 3. 3 digits it jump. So we write 10 exponent 3. Why we write 3? Why the value of the exponent is 3? Because the decimal is jumped to the 3 digit. Okay, jump over the 3 digits. And that's why the numerical value is 3. And why it is positive? Because the decimal is shift from the right side to the left side. Okay, do remember it, that when the decimal is shift from the right side to the left side, write down, note down that thing, that if the decimal shift from the right to the left, so the exponent will be positive. And when it shifts from the right to the left, the exponent will be negative. Okay. So again, here we divide after the shifting of decimal, we will divide the both the values, and then we will apply the law. 10 minus 6 is equals to 4. We divide, we subtract both the values due to the law. Okay, class, there are many ways in which we can solve the our calculation. So here we first we shift the decimal value and then we divide both the values. But you can also do it that first you divide the values and then you shift the decimal. It's depend upon your calculation and how you make your calculation easy. Okay. So do the way that in which you can easily understand the calculations and division to understand the, to solve the numericals. Okay, so the given value will become 2.439 into 10 to the power 4. Okay, so in a book the answer is again do not in a exponential form. In the book the answer is given as the in the form 24390 digit. So that how it come that we multiply 2.439 by the 10,000. Okay, 10 is to power 4 means 10,000. So when we multiply it with that value, answer is again in the form of the value which is given in our book. Now we are moving toward the next numerical. Oh, sorry, no, it's the part of that numerical. So the formula is V is equals to lambda F. And if we replace the formula, if we transform the formula according to the wavelength, it will become V over F. And if we replace the quantities by their values, the equation will become, as you can see in next step, that 3.0 into 10 is to power 10 divided by 91.9 10 is to power 6. Now what we have to do, as you can see here, first we are dividing the both the values. So we can do the calculation in both the ways. First we can divide the values, then we will shift the decimal, or first we shift the decimal and then we can divide the values. It's up to you. Okay, so try to do the calculation as you can easily understand that thing. Okay, so first we divide that two values and the answer is 0.032644. This is the decimal value of that two number. And after applying the law, the value will become 10 is to the power 10 minus 6. Okay, so 10 minus 6 is the exponential value of that 10. And when we solve it, the value remains same, the decimal value remains same, and 10 minus 6 become 4. So here the wavelength for the FM radio waves is become this. And again, when we divide the given decimal value by 10 raised to the power 4 means we have to write down in a without the exponential value, and it will become 10,000. Okay. So when we multiply it with the 10,000, the answer will become again will become in this form. And why we do it? Because it is given in a book. Otherwise, you can write the answer in the exponential value form. You can write the answer in the form which is given in a book. Okay. So take a screenshot of that slide. It will be helpful for you to do your farewell. Now we are moving towards the next slide, that is numerical number 12.4, and it is related to the pendulum. Okay, so find the time period of a simple pendulum whose length is 144 centimeter. Okay class, so do remember it that first we have to find the first we have to make a data, and in a data we have to write the given values. So in a given values the length is given, that is 144 centimeter, and now we are changing that centimeter to the meter. And why we are changing? Because if we are not changed that centimeter, so centimeter is in a CJ system, and as you can see in our next step that the acceleration due to gravity is given in meter per second square. Okay, so it is a constant value, that acceleration due to gravity, and it is given in a meter per second. So we have to change length from the centimeter to the meter, because it is a conflict that centimeter is in a CGS system and meter is in a SI unit system. So that's why we have to change centimeter into a meter, so that all the values will be in a same system. Okay, so that's why we change. As we know that 1 meter is equals to 100 centimeter, and when we are moving from the smaller unit to a greater unit, so we have to divide it with the quantity. So we divide 144 by the 100, and the answer is 1.44 meter. So we are moving toward the next slide. So take a screenshot of this slide. The required quantity is time period. Do remember it, that we have to find our time period. Okay, so we are moving to the next slide. And here is the solution of this numerical. And in this numerical, formula is given. Formula is T is equals to 2 pi under root L over G. Okay. So again, I explained that T is 10 for the time period, 2 is the constant value, and pi is the again a constant value whose numerical value is fixed, and that is 3.14 or 22 over 7. Now, root L over G. As we know that length of the pendulum is given, it always given in a numerical. And the acceleration due to gravity is again a constant value, so we replace this by 9.8. And yes, class, do remember it, that you can use 9.8, you can use 10. Okay, it's up to you. If in a numerical they will restrict you to use 9.8 or 10, then you will use 9.8 or 9.8. Then otherwise you can use both the values. You can use 9.8, you can use 10. Now, for the solution of that values, first we have to find the division of 1.44 divided by 9.8. So first we have to find that division, and that division is 0.1469. And class, do remember it, that answer will remain in the square root, okay? So first we have to find the division, and the answer will remain in the square root, and 2 will be multiplied by the 3.14. So we will also multiply that two values, and the answer is 6.28. Now, what we have to do, that first we have to find the square root of that decimal value, 0.1469. So first we have to find out the square root of that numerical value, 0.1469. Okay, so that, do not forget to find the square root of the decimal value, and the square root of this decimal value is 0.3833. And now we can multiply that value by 6.284, and the answer is 2.408 second. Okay, I hope you will understand. If you want to repeat it, I will repeat it, because its calculation is a little bit difficult. So what we are doing, we are using a formula. In this formula, we replace pi by the value 3.14 and L by the value 1.44, because it is given in a numerical, and g stand for the acceleration due to gravity. So here we are using 9.8, so you can also use 10. Okay, now how we solve it. First we have to divide both the values, 1.44 by 9.8, and the answer will become in the decimal form, as you can see in a monitor, that 0.1469 is the division factor of 1.44 divided by 9.8. and do remember that it is still remain in the square root. So now in the next step, first we have to find the square root of that numerical, that decimal value, and the answer will become 0.38. You can use it by find it by using a calculator. And now we are multiply 6.28 by the, these two values will be multiplied with each other, and the answer will become 2.4. Okay, so 2.41 second is your final answer. So take a screenshot of this slide, and we will move toward the other one. Now, 12.6. A piece of a paper complete 50 vibration in 5 seconds when some waves passes through the surface of water. So find the time period and the frequency of the piece of paper. If the wavelength of the wave is 10 centimeter, so find the velocity of the wave. So here you can see that number of vibration is 50 and the time is 5 seconds. Wavelength is 10 and the required quantity, here we have to find the three values. So do remember that here we have to find the three values: frequency, time period and wavelength. Okay, so we have to find three quantities. So take a screenshot and we will move toward the next slide. Yes, here it is the slide of for the frequency. We are using a formula, number of vibration divided by time. And why we are using now this time, why we are using this formula? Because it depends upon the numerical values, which is given in a numerical. So it depends upon the values, that what value we are using. So we choose the formula accordingly. So F is equals to 50 divided by 5. 50, as you as I told you, that 50 is the number of vibration and it doesn't have any unit because it is a quantity. So do remember it, that 50 divided by 5. And now the frequency will become 10 hertz. Now the time period. For the time period, as you can see, that T is equals to 1 over F is in a formula. So we replace F by a numerical value 10. And answer is 0.1 seconds. So take a screenshot of this slide. It is very easy that we have a frequency. So we just take a reciprocal of frequencies and we will find our time period. Okay, take a screenshot and we will move toward the next slide. Here is the third quantity, that is velocity. So we have find a frequency and wavelength is given in a numerical. So we can easily use the equation, wave equation. So that's why we use V is equals to F lambda, and for the lambda, the value is 10, and for the frequency, it values again 10. So we multiply it and the answer is 100 centimeter per second. Okay, so take a screenshot and now we are going to share our home task. Okay. So home task is, or do all the numericals on your fair copies from page number 261. And class, do remember it, that we have to do all the numericals. They all are very important. Okay. So try to do all the numericals on your rough fair copies. Some of them, we have shared some of them. And those numericals which we have not shared, it is very similar as we as all the numericals we have shared. So do all the numericals on your fair copies from page number 261. Okay. So now it's all from my side. Allah Hafiz.